Hello, so today we're going to talk about multi-magnus as a team. And this is not a comprehensive guide, it's more of what to look out for to succeed better in your gameplay. So firstly, this is the boss sequence, and I'm sure you guys have seen this like many times. And it's really, really important to know the sequence really well. It is also important to know the type of advantages that your class have in terms of survivability in Magnus, and that will help really much with your survival. And these are just some examples of the advantages. And these are the ones specifically for bishops. I will go through some of them, but if you're not a bishop, you can just skip this part. Now firstly, benediction is really good to help you dodge all the poison zones, and also to help you dodge the DOT stacks and reduce the damage done outside the blue zone. Divine Protection helps you avoid the DOT stacks too, but they don't really help you reduce the DOT outside the blue zone. And lastly, Shell allows you to tank the meteors and also the DOT outside the blue zone. So important things to survive is to dodge all the DOT debuff stacks, and also dodge all the one-hit KOs and use your class to your advantage. And that's because the higher your TOT debuff stack, the more vulnerable you are, and therefore the easier you will die. Steps to take for training: you can first get your DPS or your team members to practice in HMAX solo, and then practice as a team to survive first, and then DPSing after. So key things to remember while bossing: you want to keep the boss outside of the poison zone, and to move as a team, and also to preempt attacks early so that you can avoid them. And for more details on how to avoid better, you can check out my other video, and I will link that in the description below. And now I will try to imitate how to give commands in the boss run. So first attack is spin. Spin, stay together, clone, stay together. Okay, nice, done. And then you want to dash right, purple wave, stand under, spin, spin, down rush, stay away, down rush. And dash left. Spin, spin, clone, stand together, clone. Okay, nice. Dash right. Bishop press, and I'm on Benny. Okay, purple wave, stand under. Spin. Down rush, next attack, down rush, stay away. So at this point of time, he was asked to dash left, but he dashed right instead. And the cycle of commands, just keep repeating after this. As you can tell, knowing the sequence really well is very important for command and to play better. And also, it is very important to give commands in advance so that the DPS will know what to do and the team will know how to move in advance. Usually when I say dash left, I'm asking the bait to face the boss left so he will dash left, and vice versa. I do suggest using manual PE for all your practices and your real runs, and that's because if you use PE, it's tend to get spammed because Magnus have no CD for PE. Therefore, if you auto your PE, you may end up using 100 to 200 per run. Remember to use your iframes when you're in danger, or you can save them for the last phase. But if you're on them, you can help the team to tank some of the attacks, like Paula tanking the meteors. just want to remind you to remember to dodge all the DOT debuff stack so that you can stay alive easier, because you're not actually bleeding every second due to the stack. For example, if you have 3 stacks, you'll be bleeding 30% HP per second, and tanking any meteors or attacks after that will result in death. When first practicing, you can actually start with not using any buff, just to practice to move together and to stay alive. You may also use dumpling to help you to move faster, and you don't really need any sort of defense buff for Magnus. And I also would want to say that it is common to fail the first few runs, and just don't give up, just keep trying. And as you can see, this clone range was a bit too wide, and so I had to move further just to avoid it. Most importantly, if you die, remember to wait for command before pressing the rest button, and also check the meteors before you actually revive so that you won't die immediately after revival.
Meteor,